Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 4.3 in PERT CPM. In the earlier two lectures, we studied about the construction of the PERT network and the calculation of the various times and variance for the network. And in this lecture, we continue with the PERT computation. We will be using the forward pass computation, backward pass computation, and we will find the critical path. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to find the critical path of the PERT network. We take an example. Example number 5, a project has the following time schedule. So, activity 1 to 2. 2 months, 1 to 3, 2 months, 1 to 4, 1 month, 2 to 5, 4 months, 3 to 6, 8 months, 3 to 7, 5 months, 4 to 6, 3 months, 5 to 8, 1 month, 6 to 9, 5 months, 7 to 8, 4 months, and 8 to 9, 3 months. We have to construct the network and calculate the critical path of the network. So 1 to 2, we have 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4. And 2 to 5, 4 to 6, then 3 to 7, then 3 to 6, 3 to 6, 3 to 7, then 5 to 8, then we have 7 to 8, 6 to 9, and 8 to 9. And the time of various activities are shown above the arrow. Now we have to calculate the earliest expected time, latest completion time. We have to calculate the slack of the every event and find the critical path. Now, the network is drawn with all the values. Now, we will see how the values are calculated. TE, TL values, slack values are calculated. For the forward pass computation, we have to calculate the earliest expected time in the forward pass computation. And in the network, in the event, we divide into three. The top part is the event number. The left hand side, bottom left hand side is the earliest expected time TE value. Bottom right hand side is the latest allowable occurrence time. Now TE1 equal to 0. Initially we have to start with 0. First event is assigned 0 time. Then TE2. So there is only one incoming arrow. So TE2 equal to the time of the previous event plus the time for the activity. So TE1 plus TE12 equal to 0 plus 2 equal to 2. Then TE3, so for the event 3, again there is only one incoming arrow. So TE3 equal to TE1 plus TE13 equal to 0 plus 2 equal to 2. Then TE4 equal to again TE1, there is only one incoming arrow, TE1 plus TE14 equal to 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Then TE5, so for fifth event, again here again there is only one incoming arrow. So, TE5 equal to TE2 plus TE25 equal to 2 plus 4 equal to 6. And TE6, so for 6, there are 2 incoming arrows. Now, the maximum of these 2 timing. So, TE6 equal to maximum of TE3 plus TE36 equal to 2 plus 8 equal to 10. And TE4 plus TE46 equal to 1 plus 3 equal to 4. So, here 2 plus 8 equal to 10, 1 plus 3 equal to 4. So, the maximum value is 10. So, we assign 10 here. And TE7, so there is only one activity, one arrow entering to the event. So, TE7 equal to TE3 plus TE37 equal to 2 plus 5 equal to 7. And TE8, so here 8, we have the 2 incoming arrows. So, TE5 plus TE58 plus 6, which is equal to 6 plus 1 equal to 7. And TE7 plus TE78 equal to 7 plus 4 equal to 11. So, the maximum time equal to 11. And TE8. So, TE9 equal to again maximum of, there are 2 incoming arrow. So, maximum of TE6 plus TE69, which is 10 plus 5 equal to 15. Or TE8 plus TE89, which is 11 plus 3 equal to 14. So, the maximum value is 15. So, the maximum of the value is 15. So, all the TE value, earliest expected time for all the events were calculated. Now we calculate the, we take the backward pass computation and we calculate the latest allowable time, latest allowable occurrence time. And the, for the end event, the timing is not given. Now we assign the TE value. So TL9 equal to TE9 equal to 15. So 15 is assigned here and we go back to the 8th event. So for the 8th event, there is only one event, one activity emerging from it. So we have TE9 minus TE89. So TL8 equal to TL9 minus TE89 equal to 15 minus 3 equal to 12. So 12 is written here. And TE7. So for TE7 equal to TL8. TL7 equal to TL8 minus TE878. So which is this 12 minus 4 which is 8. So 8 is written here. And TE6. So for here there is only one going outgoing arrow. So, TL9 minus TE69 equal to 15 minus 5 equal to 10. And TL5. So, for TL5, there is only one outgoing arrow. So, TL5 equal to TL8 minus TE58 equal to 12 minus 1 equal to 11. And TL4. So, TL4 again, only one outgoing arrow. TL4 equal to TL6 minus TE46 equal to 10 minus 3 equal to 7. And TL3. So, there are two outgoing arrows. So, we have to take the minimum of the two values. So, minimum of TL7 minus T37 equal to 8 minus 5 equal to 3 and TL6 minus TE36 equal to 10 minus 8 equal to 2. The minimum value is 2. So, it is assigned 2 here and TL2. So, there is only one outgoing arrow. So, TL2 equal to TL5 minus TE25 equal to 12 minus 4 equal to 7 and TL1. So, there are three outgoing arrows. So, the minimum of TL2 minus TE12, 7 minus 2 equal to 5, TL3 minus TE13, 2 minus 2 equal to 0, TL4 minus TE14 equal to 7 minus 1 equal to 6. So, the minimum value is 0. So, 0 is assigned here. So, TE value in the left hand side of the bottom and the TL value right hand side of the bottom of the event circle. Now, we calculate the slack period. So, slack period is calculated by subtracting TL and TE. So, difference value TL minus TE. So, here 0 minus 0 equal to 0. Here 7 minus 2 equal to 5. Here 6, 11 minus 6 equal to 5. So, here 12 minus 11 equal to 1. Here for the even 3, 2 minus 2 equal to 0. For even 7, 8 minus 7 equal to 1. For even 9, 15 minus 15 equal to 0. For even 6, 10 minus 10 equal to 0. For even 4, 7 minus 1 equal to 6. So, the significance of the slack, significant, what is the meaning of the slack is, you can delay that particular event by the number given. So, that means, the event 2, 5 can be delayed by 5 days. Event 8 can be delayed by 1 day. Event 7 can be delayed by 1 day. Event 4 can be delayed by 6 days. When slack equal to 0, so, you cannot delay the event. You have to conduct the event on the calculated time. So, these events are called as critical event. The event with zero slack is called as critical event. The event with zero slack are called as R1, 3, 6 and 7. 1, 3, 6 and 7 and the activities are critical. The events are critical event and the corresponding activities are critical activities. So, for the critical activities are 1, 3 is the critical activity, 3, 6 is the critical activity and 6, 9 is also the critical activity. For critical activity, the condition is TE3 minus TE1 equal to TL3 minus TL1 equal to TE13. So, the TL value, so difference between TL value and TE value should be equal to the expected time of the activity. Similarly, 3, 6, TE6 minus TE3 equal to TL6 minus TL3 equal to TE36. For activity 6, 9, TE9 minus TE6 equal to TL9 minus TL6 equal to TE69. So, these are all the condition for the critical activities. And the critical path is 1369. So, 1369 is the critical path. Then we take another example. So, we are given a network. So, we are given a network with 8 different events and the timings are given. So, the relationship between various events in the network is also given. So, we have 1 to 2 with 10 days time, 1 to 3 with 8 days time, 2 to 5 with 18 days time, 3 to 6 with 3 days, 4 to 6 with 7 days, 5 to 6 with 2 days, 5 to 10 with 10 days, 6 to 8 with 3 days, 6 to 7 with 2 days, 7 to 8 with 3 days, 4 to 7 with 11 days. So here again we have to calculate the find out the critical path. So find the critical path of the network. That is the question. Now the forward pass computation, we have to calculate the earliest expected time. So the value of forward pass computation and the backward pass computation slack values are given in the network. We will see how to calculate the various values. So TE1 equal to 0. As usual, for the first event, we have to fix TE, earliest expected time, equal to 0. And TE2, so for the event 2, there is only one incoming arrow. So TET equal to TE1 plus TE12 equal to 0 plus 10 equal to 10. For event 3, so there is only one incoming arrow, TE3 equal to TE1 plus TE13 equal to 0 plus 8 equal to 8. And for event 4, there is only one incoming arrow, so TE4 equal to TE1 plus TE14 equal to 0 plus 5 equal to 5. And TE5, so for the 5th event, again only one incoming arrow, TE5 equal to TE2 plus TE25 equal to 10 plus 18 equal to 28. And TE6, so there are 3 incoming arrows. So TE6 equal to maximum of TE3 plus TE36 equal to 8 plus 3 equal to 11, TE4 plus TE46 equal to 5 plus 7 equal to 12, and TE5 plus TE56 equal to 28 plus 2 equal to 30. So 30 is the maximum time. So TE value for the 6th event is 30. Then TE7, there are 2 incoming arrows. So maximum of TE4 plus TE47 equal to 5 plus 11 equal to 16, and TE6 plus TE67 30 plus 2 equal to 32. The maximum time is 32. So 32 is written here. And TE8, there are 3 incoming arrows. So maximum of TE5 plus TE58, 28 plus 10 equal to 38. TE6 plus TE68, 30 plus 3 equal to 33. And TE7 plus TE78, which is 32 plus 3 equal to 35. The maximum value is 38, so TE value is 38 here. So in the forward pass computation, we calculated the TE value, earliest expected time of all the events. Now we take the backward pass computation, we will calculate the latest allowable occurrence time. So here we have to fix TL8 equal to TE8 equal to 38, because the value is not given. So the we have to fix TE value equal to TL value for the end event. And TE7, there is only one in outgoing arrow. So TE7 equal to TE8 minus TE78 equal to 38 minus 3 equal to 35. And TE6, for 6 there are 2 outgoing arrows. So minimum value, minimum of TL8 minus TE68 equal to 38 minus 3 equal to 35. And TL7 minus TE67 equal to 35 minus 2 equal to 33. The minimum value is 33. So we write 33 here. And TL5, there are 2 outgoing arrow, minimum of TL8 minus TE58 equal to 38 minus 10 equal to 28, and TL6 minus TE56 equal to 33 minus 2 equal to 31. So the minimum value is 28. So TL value is 28 for the 5th event. And for the 4th event, there are 2 outgoing arrows. Again, minimum of TL7 minus TE47 equal to 35 minus 11 equal to 24. And TL6 minus TE46 equal to 33 minus 7 equal to 26, and the minimum value is 24. So for the 4th event, minimum value is 24. And TE3, for the 3rd event, there is only one outgoing arrow. So TE6 minus TE36 equal to 33 minus 3 equal to 30. And TE2, there is only one outgoing arrow. So TL5 minus TU25 equal to 28 minus 18 equal to 10. For TL1, minimum first event, minimum of, there are 3 outgoing arrows. So TL2 minus TE12 equal to 10 minus 10 equal to 0. TL3 minus TE13 equal to 30 minus 8 equal to 22. And TL4 minus TE14 equal to 24 minus 5 equal to 19. The minimum value is 0. So the 0 is written here. So all the TE and the TL value of all the events were calculated and written in the bottom of the circle. And now we calculate the slack value. Slack value is calculated by the difference TL minus TE of all the event. So slack is 0 for the first event, slack is 0 for the second event, 10 minus 10 equal to 0, slack is 22 days for the third event, 30 minus 8 equal to 22. For the fourth event, 24 minus 5 equal to 19. For the fifth event, slack equal to 0. For the sixth event, slack equal to 3. For the seventh event, slack equal to 3. And for the eighth event, slack equal to 0. 13 minus 38 equal to 0. So, the slack indicates the days by which the event can be delayed. So, for example, the event 4 can be delayed by 19 days. Event 7 can be delayed by 3 days. Event 6 can be delayed by 3 days. Event 3 can be delayed by 22 days. Whereas, when the slack equal to 0, the activity should not be delayed. The event should not be delayed and it should be executed in the calculated time. So, the critical event with the slack 0 are 1258. So, 1258, they are the critical event, and the critical activities are 1225 and 58. So, for the critical activity, the condition is TL2 minus TL1 equal to TE2 minus TE1 equal to TE12, and TL5 minus TL2 equal to TE5 minus TE2 equal to TE25, and TL8 minus TL5 equal to TE8 minus TE5 equal to TE58. So, this is the condition for critical path. And the critical path of the network equal to 1258. So, 1258 is the critical path. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Operation Research for additional information in the subject. You can subscribe the channel. I upload all the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my WhatsApp number or mail ID for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lectures on the PET and CPM. Until then, bye-bye.